Alright, ready?
Yeah, you gotta go 3-2-1.
3-2-1, whatever. Let's go. Hey, baby, this is Dimex doing what it is I do each and every week just for you. Back with the team up. D-Nice, Real Conversation. Gonna try to do some of these shows for the summer. You know, we having that little reunion thing that's gonna be coming up on June 18th. So, you know, we gonna start doing a little taping as well out here in the summertime. Different places, hopefully some of you can join us.
Right, y'all, hopefully, like I like to reintroduce myself, is D-Nice of Real Entertainment and Real Conversation. And we also back again, dealing with Dimex, dealing with her level, dealing with the people, her fans, the ones that love me and hate me, and also the people that might be to watch my show. And I want to thank them all for putting up with me for all of our past 7 years. So we're going to do the celebration June 18th. We're going to be at the dugout. So hopefully you all can make it there. And also, I just want to interject, I still don't want any bug outs at the parties. So all you people that are confused about which bathroom to go into, you don't have to worry about that. Just don't even come, because we don't go. I don't need that. Okay? Thank
you. Well, did you hear? Now, we're going to just dive right into it. You heard about the transgenders, if you, you know, work with them or whatever, and you don't call them what they want you to call them, which is Z or her or whatever it is, that you can be fined up to $250,000.
You're joking. Are you serious about this?
That's dead serious. So you better get your act together.
That's nothing. That's freedom of speech. I can say what I want.
No, they just put it into law. And that's the funny part, because black people been trying for years to get, you know, just because I'm black, stop judging on me, stop hating on me. But yet transgenders have a law that just has been passed. If you don't call them what they want you to call them and you continuously refuse to do what they ask, you can be fined up to $250,000.
Well, that must be of a government arena. Like, I know privately, you can go in your house and you can say what you want in your house or your own club or things that you own. But now,
no, that's in the workforce. That's what I'm talking
about.
Well,
that's a government workforce. You can't go tell a private industry. In other words, can I go tell the Ku Klux Klan to let black people in?
Look, that's what I'm trying to tell you. It ain't for us. We don't get as much, you know, pull as the transgenders. And that's kind of messed up.
You
but
need
it is
to
what
confuse
it is.
People to think they men and women and women. Men think they women and women think they men. You got cross dressers. You know what? You know what? This takes me to, and I'm keeping it real like I always do. First of all, who told man to confuse the issue of what a man is and what a woman is? I'm talking about as per gender, as per role, and as per mindset. Who told them to change the natural order? That's like me telling a dog to be a bear, or telling a cow to be a bull, or telling a sheep to be a goat. How do you change what the creator made? See, this is the problem with this world. A bunch of fools have taken over, and they have established what we call sinful laws.
I mean, well, yeah, that happened before, so.
Well, it's gonna happen again. You know what happened? You know what the consequences gonna happen, right?
I mean, well, you can look around and, you know, those that don't believe in the Bible and stuff like that, a lot of signs is like similar lining up.
Why can't it just be the creator? Why only you say have to believe in the Bible? The creator shows himself in all his things. Everything.
No, but the Bible was the book, and whatever book it is that you read, whether it's your Apocrypha, you call it,
Apocrypha, King James 16:11.
I mean, whatever it is, it's those rules and laws
and all the rest of
that
books.
Talk about the locusts and the seasons changing and, you know, all this type of stuff that seems to be coming.
But that's all real. That's history. Yeah, that's history. Like, you know, like I keep telling a lot of people, right? Until you get real with what reality is, and you got to understand what is real and what's true. That's the problem with most people. They allow anybody to tell them anything, to think any way, and to allow anything. And this is what the problem with us. When are you going to stand your ground as a woman? Like, you women should be mad about men walking around with dresses. I would never.
I mean.
What?
You have, like I always say, you got the people who's Scottish.
No, hold on.
But what's happening today, it does make you feel a little weird.
A little weird?
To see. Yeah, like Will Smith's son, you know, he's the new representative for the women's line, and he wear dresses, but yeah, everybody say he's a good kid, though, that we should be looking at that he's a good kid rather than what he's wearing. But, you know, I don't know, because it influences the rest to be. Some people, that's who they are. Some people getting influenced. It is what it is.
No, it is not what it is. It's what a fool say it is and what a fool allows. The problem with everybody, and I can say this forever, ever, and ever, is that you have lost your minds. Like I keep telling you, you have no understanding. You have no common sense. You can't figure out what's right or wrong. You don't any. You have logic mode displacement. You know what? What's logical? What's logical? Should I look like a woman? Is that logical?
Well, sometimes you might act like women.
But should I look like a woman?
But I'm saying sometimes men act like women with certain things that they do. Women act like men with certain things they do.
But should they?
But that's just human nature.
That's not human nature.
But we're not talking about dressing.
That's called human confused mind. That's what
we're not talking about dressing, though.
Oh, dressing is a way a person looks and carries himself defines also how they think. So let's not get that confused. Okay, let's keep it real. And we're gonna stay real. I'm embarrassed to even be part of this generation.
Well, it's not only this generation. It's been happening for centuries.
But it's escalating away. At this level is high, what I call wickedness and pervertedness and confusion. And you know what the next generation from here 100 years is going to look back and see? And you know what they're going to say about us or this generation that lived? Could you imagine what they're going to say? Because it's recorded. It ain't like you don't have cameras now, videotapes. Enough now to say, did they really do that? See, before...
We don't know what is going to be in the future because the future is being set up from today.
You can't be for real, right? Back then, right?
No, but I'm saying the future. You said, what are they going to say about us? But the future is being set up today by what we're doing now. So the future is these people, and they're going to be okay with it because that's why they do it.
They're not going to be okay with it. We're in the present. The future comes later. Here's the problem, which you don't understand and which you don't believe. The problem with everybody is you do not want to deal with the wreckage that was in the past. We read the wreckage in the past and they already recorded what they was doing back then and they showed you the consequences. Unfortunately for today, now that you're here in this so-called new modern age of technology, you're now being recorded and you're doing every evil, wicked, perverse, stupid thing that can be recorded. And I'm glad it's recorded because this is going to be the condemnation of the world. In other words, the destruction that you must reap what you sow. Because everything turns itself all the time, just like that. You cannot get away. You cannot go turn a whole society of people, a whole generation, a nation of people, a whole world into a bunch of perverts and expect nothing to happen.
I mean, well, it's demons that's taking over. They just showing themselves, just because it's time, I guess.
Yeah, exactly. And thank God it's time. Because the time is this. It's been, like, when I used to do the show 7 years ago, when I started with you, you was all like, why you gotta say this? Why you gotta, you remember those days?
Certain things, you still, it's extra.
Only reason I'm extra because it's like you gotta hit you with a bat to get you to see what I'm talking about. So I had to go to the extreme levels, and when I went to extreme, then I got your attention. But now everything is all out of order. Like when I stopped doing so many shows, like everybody know you haven't seen me in a while. Now you're seeing everything I said come to pass. Now you allowed it in, and now this is what you got because you didn't get up there and protest. You didn't even say, no, that's wrong. So now we
got... I didn't, because to me, to each his own. Like, God got to deal with whomever. Everybody going to die. Ain't nobody getting out of here alive.
Hold on. When did it become... You ever heard, I'm thy brother's keeper, or I'm thy brother's and sister's keeper? You ever heard that?
Look, you can... You can be somebody's keeper, but they gotta make their own decision for their life.
So now when I tell them that they're gonna be destroyed, should you be mad at me because they made a choice of destruction? Should you be
but
mad?
But it's not up to you.
I didn't say what I said. The choice that they made, according to as it's been in the past, as it will be in the present, as it will be in the future, is it okay for me to tell them the consequences? Like, in other words,
you
if
can't
I start
tell
smoking,
them
for example, if I start smoking crack, and I continue to smoke crack. And you might say, you shouldn't smoke crack. But what's my ultimate end by me smoking crack?
Might be the mayor. God bless his soul.
Oh, really? Okay. All right. But anyway. Yeah, it was funny. But, you know, but if I continue to smoke crack and don't reform, I'm going to become shriveled up. I'm going to have all type of body problems and ailment and ultimately die because why? We know crack kills, dope kills, and all the rest of that. And a lot of people, and now they got a new thing now. Oh, weed is the big thing now. Oh, they legalize the weed. We can smoke weed. It's better for you than anything that's going on. And it doesn't do what other drugs do. Weed is another, it shouldn't be smoked. See, a lot of people don't understand. Like opium, that's another herb too. Like it grows as well as weed grows. But you don't use opium to inject it into your body. These are things supposed to be natural remedies that you use to drink as tea and herbs when you're sick, not to get high. Okay? So that's just one point you all got
it. Well, now they're using it for healing purposes.
Yeah.
It's always been like that. But that was that. No, it was for sale on the street in the hood. Okay? And then the government shut it down, put everybody in jail while they was doing research on it to get it into the, what do you call it, medicinal?
Yeah.
Community. So now, once everybody got locked up, got 1,000,000,000,000 years for bags of weed or whatever, you know, we're not talking about the ones that put the gunplay in there. Right. Now the government took it over, and now it's okay. And we're going to have nothing but weed facilities all over the place with a happy smile. Now, that's what's crazy.
Okay, and those people are going to have brain damage, and they're going to become lazy and slothful. They're going to be, they're not even going to want to, because you know, you ever see somebody get high all the time and smoking? They always laying back. They never doing anything really productive other than killing each other. Like, now, I know you all going to get mad at me for saying this, right? But, you know, the problem is with this, right? All drugs has a negative effect on it, you know? Now, people may say, well, drinking is a drug. No, it's not. Drinking is not a drug. Anything that you do in excess is a will have negative effect on you. But the Lord, since I'm dealing with, you know, like you all know, I'm just going to keep it real. I'm from an Israelite background. So I understand you can drink wine and strong drink, but you are not allowed to put drugs in your system. The Lord didn't commission that.
Well, I mean, weed is grown naturally. So.
Yeah, but I told you it's grown as a medical herb. There's every plant that's grown in the world. You can use it for some type of healing purposes. The problem is you do not take it and smoke it. It wasn't made for smoking. Like opium wasn't made for you to inject it in. And cocaine wasn't made for you to sniff, okay? And then whether y'all like it or not, you know, that's your problem. What you all gonna have to do is, if you was wrong, like I was wrong, because I came from that era, I came from that world, I was misled like most of you. But once I woke up, came out of my coma, I got real and I started trying to do real things.
Okay, but look, you got alcohol.
Now,
alcohol goes in your system just like the other things for your self-pleasurement. And God didn't say, just drink alcohol for your wellness. He said you can have some wine.
Well, you know, I didn't say he didn't say. I did say, I said wine and strong drink. There you go, not listening again. I said wine and strong drink. So that's what he gave you. That's the only thing you're going to find when you read the scriptures. He said he made wine and strong drink to make men merry and make women merry. Meaning he didn't want you to enjoy yourself. He wants you to have a good time. He wants you to hear some good music. He wants you to be able to have a drink. He wants you to be able to party. But the way today is, everybody's out of order with the natural way you should party and the natural way you should drink and the natural way you should have a good time.
So as a father with a daughter, does that bother you that transgender or, you know, men who want to be women are going to be going in the restroom? Because I'm sure they've been going in the restroom anyway. It just wasn't legal. It was like, oh, well, you're in the restroom. I mean, who's throwing you out? Does that bother you?
You really want to know my answer. I think everybody know what I'm going to say, but I'm going to say it for anybody who's just coming new to who I am and who you are. First of all, I don't accept no form of homosexuality. I don't accept no form of pervertedism. I don't accept the LGBT. I don't accept transgender. I don't accept none of that foolishness.
And I'm not saying do you accept it. I'm just talking about the part of the girls going to the restroom.
Even that's wrong. Only time I want to see a woman or a man go in a restroom at any time, it must be an emergency. okay, if you're going in the wrong, the men's room or the woman's room. It has to be an emergency issue. But normally, a man and a woman have to have division, separation. Women have certain needs. Men have certain needs. You was not created to go sit together and look at each other, you know, taking care of your personal health matters. Women should have their own circle and domain as well as a man. And this is how we keep the separation. This is how we keep order. If you notice, everything has order, and order creates, manifests as things to hold itself in a good standard. Without order, you have chaos. And that's what this so-called system, this so-called world, this so-called generation of people in this society have done, destroyed the natural fabric of order, which comes from the Creator.
Okay.
Yeah, well, anything else you want to know?
Well, I think you said enough.
Okay, I got something. I want to bring something to the table. How come it's so many haters? How come black people, Puerto Rican, West Indian, and the Cubans, Dominican, how come it's so much hate among us? How come people envy? Do you know why?
Because we just don't got good sense. That's it. It's nothing else, but you don't have good sense. Because if nothing for the mere fact of what's going on, how a lot of people are getting killed, and some law enforcement are doing things that they ain't got no business. And others, you know, look at, what's his name? George Kellerman, that sold the gun. Like, that's okay.
Yeah, that's
I call
fine.
Him Kellerman.
Okay.
All right, Kellerman. He sold the gun. It's okay. You know, people just getting off scot-free. And it's just like, black people, just for that alone, should be like, you know what? Let's wake up and start uniting.
Hold on a second. I said, why is so much hate among our own people? And you brought up George Kellerman.
I had to bring it up just to say, are you listening? If so much is going on that's coming from the outside world towards us, when is it going to be time to say, I think we need to wake up and start trying to love one another and unite and stop hating?
Okay, so what? Okay, I agree with you there. Because we hating each other to the point that other nations are killing us and getting away with.
Exactly.
That's what you're trying to say.
Exactly.
But I was getting into how come, like, I know, I'm gonna, you know, I ain't gonna bring out personal names, but I know when I'm among the party world and the social scene, I hear a lot of haters, and I hear them whispering and backstabbing and gang saying against me. I don't react on it because I know that they don't really know what they're doing. I know they lost their mind. My problem with them is that, how do you hate a person that you don't even know yet? This is my problem.
Well, are they hating you from TV days, or are they just hating you from, in general, they see you and they just hating on you, how you moving?
I think they hate my spirit. They hate how I move. I can feel it. Because why? I don't represent or condone or accept most of their behavior patterns. And I can speak for these old, what I call bar demon, party demon, club demon, men and women. You know, because the problem is, they coming out, and when I'm talking against the way they act, they get mad at me because I'm exposing them. I'm like, look, why are you acting like a man? I mean, why you miss trying to be a man? You're not a man. Why don't you put on some woman clothes and take off that big-ass coat and that hood and look like a woman, because that's what you are. And I'm telling the men, stop looking like women. You take off those dresses, take off your makeup, and stop acting like you are some undercover and we can't see you. Because we can see your homo asses.
Well, they're not hiding anymore.
Oh, I mean, there's a whole lot of them still hiding.
I mean, you got undercover brothers and sisters and people, of course. But we're not talking about them. We're talking about as a whole. You know, they are free now to be. They can get married. They can love one another openly.
Does it make it right? Does it make it right?
Look, like I told you, that's still going to be my stance. That's their life. I mean, the only part that bothers me about it is
the
children. Not even the grown-ups. It's the children that if you didn't want to expose that to your child and have to answer why is two men kissing, they make you have to answer. Why are two women kissing? They make you have to, you know, because children is curious. What's going on, mommy? I thought this is a man and a woman. So then you have to get in that conversation with your child maybe earlier than you want to. That part bothers me.
When are we as men and women going to take control and stop letting people that had lost their mind control us and force laws on us that are crazy and are not beneficial.
They rule the world already. Who rules the world?
Who says it? Who's ruling the world? The wicked and putting these laws in effect or
whoever they are.
If you
want to call them that, that's on you.
I'm
just saying.
No, I'm saying that. I'm not running. You're saying that.
People of all types of reality is ruling this world. Whether they racist, whether they haters, whether they are transgenders, whether they are gay, whether they are lesbian, they are ruling. They are in position. And you know what's sad? The black people that may be in position still don't got no power. You got people that are in good positions but have no power still. So that's the part that's also baffling.
Well, you know, you're a little confused. So let me try. Let me try to clear some of this up. I know the Israelites are probably okay. Don't worry about the wind. Don't worry. The wind is here.
Nah, the wind is getting in my eye.
Yeah, it's good. The health check. You see better, right? So listen. This is what I know. The Israelites are probably saying to me, D. Nice, Devon. How come you letting her get away? Why don't you just answer her? I want to say this to my Israelite brothers and sisters. I got to interject this right now. Right. But we're Israelites. You're an Israelite. You just don't wake up. You haven't woken up yet. And most of the so-called, what you call black Americans or black people in America, you are the children of Israel and the Puerto Ricans and Cubans. Our problem is this. You pay more attention to our slave masters who own us, because right now that's where we are. We're still in captivity. We're still owned. We don't really control no laws. We don't make no laws, and we certainly don't have power to tell the so-called white people and all other nations that's in this world that's controlling us to stop doing these things to us. Now, what you should ask me is, how come they doing this to us? That's what you should really say to me. And I'll tell you.
Well, we must be the chosen people. That's the only thing that would make sense.
They took crafty counsel and they created a whole bunch of diversions and wickedness and laws to keep you sinning, because they know as long as you sin, as long as you're doing the wrong thing, as long as you accept this foolishness is going on, the longer you in trouble with your creator, because we're his chosen, and the longer you're going to stay in sin, and the longer you're going to stay stupid.
And therefore,
you will be destroyed.
Well, you can go there.
I went there.
Even if you don't go there and you just amongst your own kind, you still destroying each other, and that ain't got nothing to do with what you just said.
You may I help you understand what I'm trying to say, right? You are responsible for your people, whether you like it or not. If you see your people sinning, and in the word sin means transgressing, that's all it means. Transgression is moving against what you should have been doing or should not have been doing. Like the white man tell you, we made these cars and we made a light. If you gonna ride a car, you gotta get a license and you gotta stop at a red light and you gotta go at the green light. He made laws. The Creator also made laws. And one of the laws, since we talking about this transgender, homosexual, and all this foolishness, he said man should not lay with mankind, and a woman should not lay with womankind, and a woman should not dress like a man, and a man should not dress like a woman. And all those that do that are an abomination, and they should surely be put to death. The only reason why these people are not being put to death today is because of mercy and grace, because the Most High is trying to give you a chance to figure out to repent, meaning change your ways.
Skin color is black.
We're not talking about skin color.
But you gotta talk about that, because we are all here and we are all being, you know, they have racism going on so bad and thick right now just because, like, back in the day, the color of your skin. So I didn't ask to come here. Because I'm here, I still gotta go through this.
It ain't got nothing to do with the color of your skin.
May I correct you then?
Have you ever looked at the East Indians that come to America?
No, you can tell me what you're going to say, but in every race that you name, when you got black color skin, you are the lowest part of the race. I don't care if you Indian and you a dark Indian, you are worse than the light Indian. If you are Chinese and you a dark Chinese, you worse than the light Chinese.
Right.
Like, that's just fact.
Okay,
Dominicans, you got light Dominicans, you got dark Dominicans. Everybody, every race, every culture got black in them, and all the blacks, Haitians, whatever, is always the lowest part of the totem pole, as if we ain't nothing. But if we would all unite in all those cultures, the black race, you would dominate the world.
Okay, hold on now. Let's get back. I heard what you said. So let me now interject and let me make a couple of corrections. We're not hated on just because we're dark. Now, there is an issue. I'm talking about our people. Let me, because you went to a lot of different dimensions. So I'm trying to, you know, put it all in the right perspective. First of all, the so-called black Americans, so-called black Cubans, Dominicans, and West Indians, and so forth, the darker ones, of course, we're discriminated more against. I'm talking about the children of Israel, the 12 tribes. We're discriminated against, period, because we're the Israelites. We're the children of Israel. We're God's chosen. Now, is there hatred and discrimination against light skin versus dark skin? Of course, because they rather see a light skin person over a dark skin person, because that's how the white man is set up. And I don't have to, and you know, white people don't be getting all funny. You know, reality is reality, getting real is real. You know you do this, you know you discriminate, and the funny thing is, why they always trying to get tans? You know, if you don't like being dark, or you don't like people be dark, how come they trying to get so many tans? And how come they buying the melon? And how come they killing us for our organs in our melon?
But you know what I saw the other day? I saw somebody who was real dark, like blue-black dark, and I found myself looking at the person like, wow, they're really dark. And I had to say, like, wow, so is that how white people look at us?
Yeah, you're a little damaged. So anyway, you're a little damaged.
Well, if I'm a little damaged, you're a lot damaged.
It's
just fact.
So let's keep going. So in America, right, like an East Indian that's darker than me and you come from India. You know, India on the other side of the world. You come over here, they allow him all type of benefits, set up businesses in our neighborhood. That goes for Arab, that goes for African, that goes for Egyptian. They don't discriminate against them. They tell them, go into the blacks and Puerto Ricans, Jamaican, West Indian communities, set up business, set up shop, and sell to them. But the word is, don't allow our own kind to do it. Because they don't give us the money and the grant.
But when we have businesses, we don't want to patronize one another because we're so busy trying to be better than
each other. Well, that's going back to hatred. But where do we learn it from? Who taught us, like Malcolm X said, who taught us to hate ourselves? See, our problem is simple. You have been self-taught to hate yourself. Not only do you hate yourself, you hate your own kind, you hate the people, you even hate yourself and you don't even know.
Nah, I don't do all that. I hate what my own kind do.
I want to say this. You see how the black women right now today, or the black men, so-called black men, I'm talking about all the tribes, the Puerto Ricans, the West Indian, Cuban, the men, everybody trying to bleach their skin, look white, everybody trying to get blonde hair to look like some white, stupid white girl, some ditzy blonde hair.
Because they don't want to be black. And they don't want what God gave
them. And you know why you don't want it? Because you've been self-taught to hate yourself, to look at another image and emulate that image.
You just said white people trying to get full of lips. When they do it, Kim Kardashian, her butt is big. Oh, wow, big butt is in. Oh, wow, she got lip injection. Oh, big lips is in. We've been having big butts, big lips.
You went to the white people trying to be us.
Yeah, because you're saying self-hatred. We trying to be them, they trying to be us.
It's a confusion on both sides. White women and white men trying to be dark, and black people trying to be white. So there's confusion on both parts. But the key is...
It's different levels.
It's what it is. It's saying there's confusion going on in the world. And the key to clearing this foolishness up is to get real and tell the truth.
What is their style, though? Because I had a blonde wig on. I look good.
That ain't no style. If you really want to have
style... For me, it was. I'm a hairstylist. you know, with a license, and that's what we do. We look different. We want to look different. You know, we enjoy it.
You know what the problem is?
But I don't. I'm not trying to be a white woman.
You know what? Like our rap artists, right? If you notice, all these performers, instead of them being real and perform positive music, these clowns went and promoted music that destroys their own kind. And that's what you, hairstylists, that's what you people in the fashion world, you have created fashion, you have created looks, you have destroyed your own people, and you are so damaged and so destroyed that you can't even understand that you have done that to your own kind.
You gotta understand who got the power.
Because, I didn't, you didn't know, nobody, hold on, hold
because
on.
Because if you, no, if you, no, 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 if you have a girl, if you have a girl and she was doing her prom and she was told that kente cloth is not going to be suitable for to make her dress, okay? But she did it anyway and it went viral because it was beautiful. So people are controlling the masses out here. And when you try to get your own, like Black Wall Street, you still get destroyed. So even when you try to say, I'm going to separate, we're going to try to do our own, we're going to stick together, we're going to do it, you still get destroyed.
Listen to me. I told you, you're still in the land of your enemy, your slave master.
What are you talking about?
Nobody told you got to go wear a blonde wig.
Nobody told you, but if people wear purple, red, green,
my whole point is, you do a lot of things you don't have to do because you're self-destroyed. Like in other words, for example, if I told you today, listen, Dimex, you should not eat pork any longer. Now, I know you've been eating pork, and I know you love it.
I don't eat it a lot anymore.
I'm starting to think of vegetarian,
because I'm looking like they got pigs down there. It's pets, so how you going to be eating your pets?
Hold on, let's stay focused on what I'm trying to say, right? You try to sidetrack it, but they ain't going to get away, right? There's certain things, even in your captivity, you still don't have to do what masters say.
You ain't doing what he say.
Yeah, then why do you want to do? Okay, no, you know what? Now I'm glad you said that. See, I told you, you were dealing. Now you're on a different mindset. You know what you said? Do what you want to do?
You're doing what you want to do.
And you know what that means when you do what you want to do?
What?
That you pay the penalties. I can do anything I want. But everything I do has consequences. But I told you, you are a special people created by the Creator, and He's a jealous God, and He would not allow you to do whatever you want to do without your consequences. And the one reason why you in captivity and slavery and complaining about we dying and confused and hating is because you choose to do the thing that doesn't please the Creator that made you. Do as thy will. That's satanic.
Well, you do that all the time.
I don't know. You know what? I want to say this. I'll say it anywhere, right? I'll be the first one to say I done did everything wrong. But what makes me different from you, Dimex, and a lot of you viewers out there, I reckoned with my mind and my spirit, and I realized I was wrong. So therefore, the first thing you got to understand is, am I right or am I wrong?
That's
the first
thing.
Hold on a second. Let me finish, because this is a basic thing everybody needs to understand. You got to figure out, are you right or wrong in what you're doing? And then when you figure that part out, then you gotta say, do I correct myself or do I continue in my error? And then whatever choice you make, then either you're gonna be blessed or you're gonna be cursed. That is about as simple as it goes.
Like I said, right here on TV, two people, you always was hating on me, doing dumbness for no reason that I didn't even deserve.
What are you talking about?
I think he's sitting over here.
Oh, yeah. Hold on.
And reach to the hound.
Long Ranger.
Why do you do what you do?
Hold on a second.
Okay, and, you, and like